the Avs. They're sporting a record this season of 5-6, and for the Warriors, and they might be looking forward to the next time these teams play, because the Golden Hawks, not terribly good at home with a record 1-5, but on the road they're 4-1, sizzling. And as Coach Slip told us before the game in our meeting with him, he said this is a team that is set up in terms of character and toughness to stay in games. Won't blow out a lot of teams unless the team plays them really softly. But the Laurier Golden Hawks are a team that will work hard for the entire 40 minutes, and they showed that against Windsor, where they played an awful first half and then came back and played very well in the second half, eventually losing that game less than a week ago by a score, a week ago by 20 points. But it was really that first half that just killed the Golden Hawks against Windsor, a number one team. The Warriors also played Windsor this past week, along with Western, losing both those games, losing against Western 87-59, but only trailed by 7 at the half, and then dropping the game against Windsor 86-39. We'll take a quick break to bring it down to courtside for the playing of the national anthem here at the Physical Athletics Complex on the campus of the University of Waterloo. Live rendition of the national anthem here at the PAC, and we get set for the starters for the visiting Laurier Golden Hawks under their head coach Paul Falco, assistant coaches Cal Kale, Renetta Adamsick, and Carrie Gilson. They start number 4, Liana Hosai, a 5'2 guard out of Toronto via the University of Miami, where she played last season. Number 5, Amber Hillis, a 5'3 guard in her fifth year out of Hamilton. Number 11, Doreen Bonsu, a 5'6 forward in her third year out of Hopeville. Number 12, Kimberly Yeldon, a 6' forward in her third year out of Ottawa. And number 6, Laura Doyle, a 5'7 guard in her third year out of Guelph. For the hometown Warriors, a very injury-riddled squad, they start number 4, Jackie Rodriguez, number 7, Kenzie Lohe, number 15, Sam McIntyre. McIntyre with a great game against Windsor with 13 points, but 11 turnovers in that ballgame. Number 21, Kate Quincy, and number 23, Erica Person. The head coach is Tyler Swift in his fifth year. Assistant coaches Dara Bumstead and Greg Henhock. And the number of scratches, almost as many folks as the Warriors have suited up right now. Vanya Durek, Janelle Ullman, Laura Bosser, Laura Burnett, Alicia Hoffman, Kayla Carl, and Marty Colleen, and Allie Vonk, all scratches. And we'll get into a little more detail about the injury situation as this game goes on, but we get set for tip-off. Our officials tonight here at the PAC are Greg Spagnoli, Paul Colley, and Farnood Kazazadeh. And the tip is initially won by Yeldon, but right into the hands of Lohied, and Rodriguez takes it up top, being guarded by Hillis. She'll get into the corner to Person. Person driving into the paint. The right-hand hook gets that one to drop right away, and the Warriors have a very quick lead just 18 seconds into the ballgame. Osei to the far side to Hillis. Hillis into Yeldon. Yeldon facing up on Quincy outside to Hillis. She'll drive into the paint. She'll put up a shot. That one's strong. Rodriguez down with the rebound. and Jackie will push the ball down court quickly. She'll drive in, ran right into Osai. Loose ball, and fortunately for the Warriors, as Sam McIntyre grabbed it, put it right into the hands of Yeldon, who was standing out of bounds. So Warriors ball, as the shot clock will be run down. Again, temporary shot clocks and a scoreboard here at the pack, so things have to be manually run down. So they'll have 16 on the shot clock for McIntyre to inbound. Crowd continues to pile in here to the pack. Tonight is Varsity Night, Battle of Waterloo. So at halftime, there'll be some festivities going on. And reminder that we've got a whole bunch of games coming up here at home. Can see with the, from the quick inbound pass from McIntyre, and a nice stroke from about 14 feet near side gets it to drop, and it's 4-0 Warriors lead early. Played just about a minute of this first quarter. Switch is made, and Yeldon had an open look for a 15-footer. That one doesn't quit strong, and Rodriguez grabs her second rebound of the game. She'll get to the right wing, fakes the using the screen from Loheed into the corner into McIntyre. 15 on the shot clock. The high post to Loheed. Backing in on Monsu under the basket. Kicks it outside Rodriguez for three near side. That one's a bit short. Tried to follow it. And down with the rebound was Doyle for the Golden Hawks. Hillis into Osai. Bounces into Monsu. Gets right around Loheed, who stays with her, over to Yeldon. Yeldon to the right side. Kisses it off the glass and it drops. As Kinsey didn't have that lateral movement going quite fast enough to stay with Yeldon. Warriors lead 4-2, 8:16 to go, and Laurier obviously watching game tape from the tough game that the Warriors had at Western, where they had a whole bunch of violations just getting it over half court. Kinsey has the ball knocked out of bounds by the much shorter Doyle, and some substitutions coming in as Gius Garopoulos comes in along with the Warriors' Sweva Kulendevelin. They replace Loheed and McIntyre. 8:05 to go in the first quarter. Warriors just three on the shot clock. Couldn't see outside to Skoropoulos, and the shot clock expires. As Coach Slip just reminding the Warriors to communicate. It didn't look like Kate realized there was just four on the shot clock. 7:59 to go in the first quarter. Warriors leading 4-2. This is a Golden Hawks team. Quite a bit different than in past years. Nice play by Kulendevelin, knocking the pass intended for Osai out of bounds. Will remain Golden Hawks ball with 20 seconds to go. They lob it into Yeldon down low with Quincy, and Kate had to reach in, and she'll pick up her first foul of the game. First team foul on the Warriors. And Yeldon will go to the line. First shot is good. Yeldon on the season, a 64% free throw shooter. Second one short. Kate and Gia get stuck into each other, but Kate comes down with it for the Warriors. 7:45 to go in the first quarter. Warriors leading 4-3 as Rodriguez pass intended for Pussin. A little bit too strong. Substitution for the Golden Hawks as Yeldon takes a seat in her place. Whitney Eleanor, a 6'3 forward in her third year out of Pickering for the Golden Hawks. Warriors put on a bit of a press, and Kate thwarts that long bomb pass into Eleanor from Osai. It'll remain Laurier ball, 19 on the shot clock. Shank in the game as well for Laurier. Backing up is Hillis, uses a screen from Eleanor, tried the pick and roll, and Eleanor gets stuck in the corner, swings it back up into Hillis, then into Osai, three on the shot clock. Osai with the shot rattles out, and the long rebound picked up by Skoropoulos. 7:13 to go in this first quarter. Warriors still lead 4-3, jumped out to a quick 4-0 lead, but haven't scored since. Kinsey with a nice move on Eleanor, but then had the ball knocked away as she brought it down. Let pass again into Eleanor, who finishes off the glass. Nice pass from Osai. Chapeau coming about to come into the game along with Yeldon. Pass intended in the corner to Coolin Devlin, knocked out of bounds by Laurier. Osai takes a seat. She'll be replaced by Chapeau. Coolin Devlin up into Kunsi. Tate bounces it over to Person. She'll put up the shot. That one's strong. Down with the rebound. He is Shank. Shank, quick outlet pass once again. This time into Chapeau, who's not able to finish, but down there is Luciani, and Luciani wasn't able to grab it. Down with it was Rodriguez out of that melee. To Person for a long two. That one's a bit strong. Coolin Devlin grabs it, but had her tippy-toe right on the baseline. Warriors turn the ball over. And another outlet pass, this time to Eleanor, and she's fouled by Quincy. That'll be Kate's second foul, and will in all likelihood result in her taking a seat. As Loheed, Maddie Bear, and Natasha Stojakovic come in for the Warriors, replacing Spiropoulos, Person, and Quincy. Eleanor's at the line to shoot two. It's 6-4, Laurier leads, 6:15 to go. Eleanor, 14 of 18 so far this season, for 78%, and shows us why with a nice couple of free throws right there. 7-4, Laurier leads, 6:09 to go in the first quarter. Rodriguez uses a screen from Concede, driving in, couldn't lay it in, however, from the right side, and Eleanor comes up with it. Shank. She'll dive right side, gets around Rodriguez, who just gave her a couple of inches. Coach Slip telling us again, one of those keys to the game for the Warriors is use their size and don't play soft. This is a team, the Laurier Golden Hawks, that will take advantage. They're just very consistent, very tough, and if you play soft, if you miss your assignment, aren't in the right position at the right time, it's going to kill you, and we've seen that so far for the Warriors. That last play, Rodriguez just needed to take that extra step, block the lane to the basket, and Shank was able to take advantage. 9-4, Laurier leads. Shank picks up her first foul, first team foul on Laurier. Coolin Devlin inbounds it into Bear. Bear back from injury. Swinging it over to Coolin Devlin. Bounces in it a little bit, but right through her legs, and up with it are the Golden Hawks. Osai tried to get it into the paint, and it's loose balls picked up by Kenzie. Kenzie gets it up to Rodriguez. Approach the midway point of the first quarter. Warriors trailing by 5. It's 9-4. Rodriguez thought about a 3. Tried to get into a high post. Knocked away by the Golden Hawks. And Bear grabbed it. And Bear tried to get into Kunsey. It knocked away again. Now top of the key where Kate gets the ball. 4 on the shot clock. She'll put up a shot. It's too soft. Down with the rebound is Luciana. Osai quickly into Bruce. Pardon me, into Chapeau. As Rodriguez is replaced by McIntyre. Coolin Devlin is replaced by Person. 4:46 to go in the first quarter. Warriors trailing by 5. Laurier with possession. Shank puts up the jumper. That rattles out. Fight for the rebound. And McIntyre, who played in the forward position last season, now playing more of a guard role with a lot more bigs on the Warriors, grabbed the rebound. Luciani saves it from going out of bounds right to Loheed. Loheed over to Stojakovic, who nails the deuce from just beyond the charity stripe and brings the Warriors within 3. It's 9-6. 4:15 to go in the first quarter. Osai uses a screen from Eleanor. In that pick and roll, Eleanor didn't cut to the basket, and Erica stepped into the passing lane, steals the ball. 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. Warriors trailing by 3. Person getting around Luciani, driving into the triple team, and Luciani rejects her out of bounds. 12 on the shot clock. Quincy, Spiropoulos coming in, replacing Stojakovic and Loheed. Bonsu and Yeldon back in, replacing Eleanor and Luciani. Doyle will replace Chapu. McIntyre, better inbounded very quickly, does so to Quincy, well off on the perimeter right wing. Trying to get into Spiropoulos, into traffic, and knocked it about bounds by Bonsu. 7 on the shot clock as Coach Slip calls out the play. 3:49 to go in the first quarter. Warriors trailing 9-6. Pardon me, it was Laurier who gets possession there. Looked like it went out of bounds on Bonsu. Doyle bounces into Bonsu, facing up on Spiropoulos, gets past Spiropoulos, kicked into the corner, and he held it. Nice move. And they're going to call a foul on Quincy. Could have been a walk, it looked like. Yeldon had moved the pivot foot, but to no avail. As Kate, I believe that picks up her third foul, and Loheed immediately come in to replace her. We mentioned Yeldon, a 64% free throw shooter. Yeldon in her third year from St. Pius High School in Ottawa. Last season averaged 9.5 points and 7 rebounds a game. This is the first free throw. This season, Yeldon averaging just that exact same amount, 9.5 points per game. Her second one is also short. Loheed with a strong rebound as Bonsu tried to knock it away. Kenzie hands it off to Erica. Erica into Spiropoulos. Turnaround jumper is off to the left. Gia couldn't miss in the shoot-around before the game. A little stutter step from Doyle, and then she nails the three. 12-6 as the Laurier Goldenhawks are doubling the Warriors with 3:08 to go in the first quarter. McIntyre races to the far side, then pulls up at the perimeter, up to Person, and to the left wing in Spiropoulos, one-on-one with Yeldon. 10 on the shot clock, up to McIntyre. She'll lob it to the far elbow, into McKenzie. Loheed into Spiropoulos, 3 seconds to go. Spiropoulos puts up the shot, but she traveled. Hillis will come in. She'll replace Osai. And Rodriguez will replace Hare for the Warriors. Warriors started off hot with four quick points in the first minute. Since then, have just managed 2 more points. So they trail 12-6 with 2:45 to go in the first quarter. Hillis bounces it up into Doyle. Doyle to Bonsu. Back over to Hillis. Up into Schenck. Shot is off, and it will be Warriors ball. So Denham Buchanan and some of the male Warriors courtside enjoying some of the women's action as they get set for their game at about 8 o'clock here on SSN Canada. Check that link. Person pulls up and her three rattles around, bringing the Warriors within 3. It's 12-9, 2:10 to go in the first quarter. Doyle gets the pass from Schenck. She'll put up a 3, trying to answer back. That one's short. Person knocked it over to Loheed, and the Warriors, with less than 2 minutes to go in the first quarter, bring the ball into the front court. Rodriguez had Doyle right in her face, swung it over to the top of the key into McIntyre. His pass intended for Loheed, knocked away by Yeldon. Outlet pass to Bonsu, who is fouled. Late foul by McIntyre, and Bonsu will go to the line, and a timeout called by Coach Slip. As the Warriors giving up a lot of those outlet passes for some easy play-ins and baskets by Laurier. 1:39 to go in the first quarter. Warriors trailing the Golden Hawks 12-9.
Sweat is dripping down off my nose into the threat. Tell my story always. gotta face him. I'm ready to settle the score. In the air, the enemy.
Back here at the back on the campus of the University of Waterloo, I'm Sam Charles. You're watching Warriors basketball, women's basketball on SSN. Warriors trailing 12-9 with 1:39 to go in this first quarter. Bonsu at the line. And Fitzstrong on first. Bonsu on the season, a 63% free throw shooter. Second one's up. That one is good, and it's 13-9. Laurier leads Waterloo. Rodriguez, Pearson, Sporopoulos, Loheed, and McIntyre on the floor. Sporopoulos swinging it to the corner into Pearson, who's already made a three from long range. The high post into Loheed. Loheed facing up and then turning around on Bonsu. Outside Rodriguez. She'll dive in. Nice pass into Sporopoulos, who kisses it off the glass down low. Good court sense and vision by Rodriguez to draw that defender, and she had an open lay-in right underneath the basket. 1:05 to go here, first quarter. Yeldon swinging around almost, and she did deke herself out down low. Bonsu will put up the shot. That one's strong. Lohi down with a rebound. Less than a minute to go in the first quarter, and the Warriors have a chance to get right back to tie this ball game. Sporopoulos loses her dribble and then kicks it outside to McIntyre. She'll drive in, puts up the right hook off the glass, and it falls. And this game's tied up at 13 with 42 seconds to go in the first quarter. Bruce to Doyle. Over to Bonsu. 30 seconds to go, and then a whistle down low. Going to go against Yeldon. She and Sporopoulos battling it out in the paint, and the Warriors have a chance to take the lead. Again, the Warriors jumped out to a four-point lead. One minute into the game, and then have slowed down, but have come out on fire since that timeout. 20 seconds to go in the quarter. Loheed and Sporopoulos turning around on Eleanor. That one is an air ball. Bonsu grabs it. Before a jump ball was called, it looked like McIntyre had a hand on the ball, stepped out of bounds. Doyle replaced by Chapeau. Bonsu also takes a seat, so it'll be Bruce, Osai, Hillis, Chapeau and Eleanor for the Golden Hawks. 8 seconds to go in the quarter. They kick it out to Osai, just inside the perimeter. Instigates some contact. Blocked by McIntyre. Puts up the shot that doesn't go, and time expires in this first quarter. Well defended there at the latter stages by Sam McIntyre on the one-time NCAA player from the University of Miami, Leanne Osai. So at in between quarters here, between the first and second, the Warriors and Golden Hawks are knotted up at 13. We'll take a look. You're watching Warriors women's basketball on SSN. Back at the pack on the campus of the University of Waterloo as we get set for the start of the second quarter with the Warriors and Golden Hawks knotted up at 13 apiece. Keys to the game for the Laurier Golden Hawks, according to their head coach Paul Falco. He said they need to play great defense and win the battle of the boards that if they can do that for 40 minutes, the offense should feed off the defensive play, and hasn't really worked out so far with that scenario. Laurier has obviously watched the tape. They tried to pressure the Warriors, who've been doing a better job getting the ball into the front court. And they've tried those outlet passes, as the Warriors have been a bit sloppy on defense, getting back in position. Osa into Bruce. Bruce gets past Person, then kicked it outside. Lucky that Chapu is there to grab it. Chapu hands it off to Osai. Osai will drive into the right side, and she's hip-checked by Person. Erica just tried to get in the right position, and a little too aggressive in doing so. That'll be the first team foul on the Warriors early on here in the second quarter. They wait for the shot clock to wind down to 14. The Golden Hawks will inbound to Eleanor, up to Luciani. Gets it down, and Eleanor, who gets it off high off the glass, over McIntyre and in, and it's 15-13. Laurier leads Waterloo. Rodriguez found some daylight, and then it was some good swarming defense by Laurier. Had to kick it outside. They eventually get into Loheed. The shot doesn't go. Picked up by Laurier, but then it goes out of bounds. It will be Warriors' ball. So Jakovic comes in. She'll replace Loheed. Natasha to St. Mary's in Kitchener. Seeing some of her first action. First action against Western this past week. 9:18 to go in the second quarter. Warriors trailing 15-13 as the crowd continues to file into the pack. It's a varsity night battle of Waterloo tonight, and should be some fun halftime festivities here at center court. Rodriguez, well off on the perimeter, into the corner to McIntyre. Down into Kunze, has it knocked out of bounds by Luciani. So they'll start it again, this time with 11 on the shot clock. McIntyre inbound, into Person. Pass intended for Skoropoulos, knocked out of bounds, and then picked up for a sloppy play by the Warriors, just laziness by Skoropoulos, who needed to pick it up, and Luciani grabbed it, and that's what Coach Slip was talking about. You can't have those lapses in your focus. Person, quick jumper from the far elbow. Bringing the Warriors within two, it's 17-15. Chapu outside to Osai. Into Bruce, that one doesn't go. Person knocks it over to McIntyre, and Sam gets herself some room, and then immediately getting into Rodriguez. Rodriguez out to McIntyre. The Person being given that left side. She'll go right, though, using a screen from Stojakovic. The shot's a bit short. Skoropoulos a little lip getting to the corner. Picked up by Bruce. Again, another outlet pass. This time, Chafu pulls up. Bree's shot doesn't go for the Golden Hawks. Loose ball picked up by Chafu. Over to Osai. Down into the paint to Luciani, who loses her footing, and a foul is called. It'll go against Rodriguez. Hill is about to re-enter the game for Laurier, replacing Bruce, and Bear replaces Skoropoulos. Warriors trailing by two with 7:58 to go in the second quarter. 20 on the shot clock, quickly into Eleanor, shot high off the glass, doesn't go, grabs her own rebound right out of the arms of Starakovich, the only player on this court on either team that could probably reach Natasha's the ball above her head. As both players, Natasha on the roster is 6'4", and Eleanor is 6'3", listed as 6'3". Shank will come in. She will replace Chapu. McIntyre, inbounding, has it stolen the inbound pass to Osai, hands it off to Shank. She'll push the ball up court. Into Hillis, try to head fake. That didn't work, so Hillis gets it outside to Osai for three. That one's well short, and almost a good box out by Bear, who didn't quite have the right side boxed out. Osai kicks it outside to Luciani for three from the far corner, hits it. And a timeout quickly called by Coach Slip. With 7:15 to go in the second quarter, Warriors trailing by 4, pardon me, now by 7. It's 22-15. We'll take another break. You're watching Warriors women's basketball on SSN.
I'm ready to settle the score. Ocean in the air, the enemy in front of me. I am a warrior, glory will be mine. I'm on the shine, just wait and see. I am a warrior, a day of reckoning. I see everything, I know what I'm for. I am a warrior.
Back here at the back on the campus of the University of Waterloo, I'm Sam Charles. Thanks for joining us for Warriors women's basketball. As the timeout just wraps up, Warriors trailing by 7. As a couple of mental lapses and just sloppy play by the Warriors have enabled the Golden Hawks to once again take a lead in this ball game. Warriors led right from the get-go. First minute, they were up by 4 points, and then slowed right down. And now try to gain some momentum once again. First has the ball stripped by Eleanor as she tried to drive in from the right side. Another outlet pass by the Golden Hawks. Luciani manages to save it. Eventually gets a shot from Hillis. That doesn't go, but there with the rebound is the lanky forward for the Golden Hawks, Eleanor, who banks it off the glass, and it's 24-15, 6:40 to go in the first half. Rodriguez nearly throws it away into McIntyre. McIntyre goes left, outside to Person, for three. That one's just short. Hillis comes up it, up into a side on a three-on-one. Rodriguez, pretty tough when you have the Golden Hawks running that three-on-one to perfection as they get it right to the open wing player, easily laid it in from the left side. And again, another timeout called. The Warriors already a bit short-handed as injuries galore for this squad so far this season. Vana Jurek, concussion earlier this season, hasn't even been at school because of some of those issues. Janelle Ullman, who's been really getting some decent minutes, certainly this second half of the season, sprained her foot, a ligament in her foot in the Western game wearing a boot. Maybe back next week. Laura Bossers with a high ankle sprain suffered against Lakehead. An MRI, she's actually at the hospital right now getting an MRI. Person for three, using a screen from Lowy. That doesn't go. Eleanor with a nice box out and grabs the rebound up to Osai. Alicia Hoffman, concussion in training camp. Maybe back soon. Marta Colleen is still suffering as a nice play with the little floater from Hillis. It's now 28-15. Hakunsi about to come into the game for the Warriors along with Kulan Develin. Rodriguez into the corner to Bear. Pull-up jumper from 8 feet. That one's strong. McIntyre with a nice rebound. Turnaround jumper. That one's off. McIntyre with 13 points in the game against Windsor. The Warriors press trying to get a turnover from Laurier to no such luck, and then Shank with a strong move to the basket, and that'll have Rodriguez picking up her second foul of the ballgame. But with McIntyre's 13 points against Windsor, it went along with 11 turnovers. Bear and McIntyre take a seat, Colin Develin and Kunze come in. Osai, Luciani, and Eleanor are out. Samantha Jacobs, a second-year player out of Enniskillen, he is in along with Bonsu and Yeldon. Yeldon grabs the rebound off the free throw miss. We ask Coach Falco of the Golden Hawks whether or not they coordinate these games against Waterloo like a regular home game or being on the road, and he says it is basically like a home game with no travel, so they let the players come in on their own. Another basket by the Golden Hawks as they're now more than doubling the Warriors. 31-15, 4:54 to go in the first half. Person and Rodriguez. She'll get into the paint isolated with Hillis and then has the ball knocked away by Hillis, but Jackie will go to the line. And as she does that, Coach Slip quickly calls the four other players on the court. Right to the bench for instruction. Rodriguez misses the first. Jackie on the season, a 79% free throw shooter. Second shot's up. It's good. Warriors, after one quarter of play, were tied 13-all, but have only scored 2 points here in the second quarter compared to Laurier's 13, already matching their output for the entire first quarter. Yeldon. A spin move doesn't work, though. It's shot short, and it goes out of bounds off of Jacobs. Doyle will enter the game, replacing Schenck. Warriors shot 41% against Western last week, and also 33% on the weekend against Windsor. Shot about 30% in that first quarter. Right now, the Warriors shooting 33% compared to Laurier's 43% from the field. 40% from the field. Monsu up top to Doyle. Doyle into Yeldon, who got the elbows right up. But it causes Lohi to pick up a foul. Greg Henhock, one of the assistants for the Warriors, giving some instruction of how to thwart that sort of offensive attack from Yeldon the next time. And again, the Golden Hawks doubling the Warriors. It's 32-16, just under 4 minutes to go in this first half. Yeldon makes the back end as well. Warriors have just been to the charity stripe once, one of two. That was just moments ago. Laurier have already been to the line 11 times. They're 5 of 11. Person into Rodriguez. Nice pass into Lohi. Double team down low. Couldn't quite put enough English on the ball. It's knocked out of bounds, but the official right on the baseline, that's Greg Spagnoli, says, pardon me, that's Paul Coley, says it went off Lohi. 3:40 to go in this first half. Warriors trailing 33-16. Warriors 0-11 on the season. Laurier 5-6. Person gives Doyle a shot in the back as she goes by and hands it off to Hillis. 4 on the shot clock. Into Jacobs. The shot's just short. And Kinsey knocks it right over to Lohi. Person from the left wing tried to lob it into Kinsey, and Kinsey doesn't take that aggressive move out to try to corral the pass, and instead picked up by Laurier. They get into Bonsu, who travels, and there's a time when it just goes to show that if you hustle in a game, as Jackie Rodriguez just did, you're going to force some turnovers by the opponents. And Bonsu, Hillis replaced by Osai and Eleanor. So Jackie running in to the corner of her eye, got Bonsu to just hesitate just that one little bit, and she ended up traveling. Lohid, pass intended for Kinsey as she's knocked to the ground by Yeldon. For Yeldon, that'll be first foul. Pardon me, her second foul, the second team foul on Laurier. The Warriors at 4 team fouls, 2:44 to go in this first half. Warriors are 7-21 from the field as Person misses her shot. Coolin Devlin with the rebound. Kinsey with a nice move down the baseline. Handed it off to Lohid. And jump ball is called. Possession arrow heading in the Warriors' direction. Coolin Devlin will be inbounding. Lobs it up into Kinsey. Back over to Coolin Devlin in the corner. As heads-up move by Kate, knocking it off the Laurier defender out of bounds. It will remain Warriors' ball, but just 12 on the shot clock. And the Warriors turn it over from the inbound. Jacobs into Osai. Cross-court pass thrown into the crowd by Osai. Intended for Doyle. 2:19 to go in the first half. Warriors trailing 33-16. Warriors with just 3 points in the second quarter. Lougheed, right hook, bit too strong. Couldn't see there through the double team. Put the ball on the floor. That was a mistake. And then it's called on the 3 second violation. McIntyre and Shapu will come in for their respected teams, replacing Kulin Devlin and Jacobs. 2:03 to go in the first half. Warriors trailing 33-16. Osai on the left wing. It's a little separation. And the loose ball picked up by Bear.
Who's in there?
Osai tried to get it into Luciani in the post. Quincy for a long range deuce. That one's strong. Down with the rebound, though, is Bear. And a jump ball called again. Possession arrow heading in the Warriors' direction. And a timeout called by the Golden Hawks, who currently lead by 17. It's 33-16. We'll take a quick break. You're watching Warriors Women's Basketball on SSN. Back here at the back on the campus of the University of Waterloo, I'm Sam Charles. You're watching Waterloo Warriors Women's Basketball on SSN, brought to you by the University of Waterloo Athletics Department. GoWarriorsGo.ca for the latest in recreation and varsity athletics here at the University of Waterloo. It's this cross-town rivalry that hasn't been all that adversarial in the last few years, as the Warriors have been having their own difficulties with the Golden Hawks. Last victory for the Warriors against the Golden Hawks coming at the pack on October 29, 2008. It's a 52-49 victory. But in the last few years, it's been all Golden Hawks all the time. 90 seconds to go in the first half. Warriors trailing 33-16. Osai with the ball. Top of the key uses a screen from Eleanor. Kicks it up top to Luciani. Wide open look for three. That one's well short. Eleanor there, however. Shot goes off the bottom of the iron. Loose ball picked up by Doyle. And then a whistle down low. And 1:15 to go. Sporopoulos replaced by Kunze. And for Kunze, just to confirm this with our official stats, believe that's her fourth foul. And it is her fourth foul. Doyle makes good on both, and it's 35-16, 1:15 to go in this first half. We thank the Associate Sports Director, Athletic Director here at the University of Waterloo, Christine Stapleton, for the shout-out on Twitter. The long-range shot by Bear is short. Down with the rebound is Doyle for Laurier. And then Rodriguez steps right in between Doyle and Osai, hands it off to Person, who's too strong in the lay-in attempt from the right side. Inbound pass intended to Sporopoulos, knocked away, and Rodriguez saved it from going out of bounds, but right into the hands of a Golden Hawk. Hillis into Doyle, three from the near side, hit that one, and it's 38-16, less than 30 seconds to go in the first half. And the one thing that Coach Slip was especially concerned about was these Warriors could not afford to be sloppy against a team that plays good fundamental basketball. He said there's no stars on the Golden Hawks. There's nothing that oppresses you when you watch their games, but they are just a very steady team with a lot of toughness. And a nice play by Person being guarded closely by the much taller Eleanor. Gets the shot to fall, and she'll go to the line for a three-point play opportunity. 5 seconds to go in half. Person's free throw attempt is strong. Luciani comes up with it over to Chapu. Chapu hesitates, puts the shot up before the buzzer, but it's well short. And that's where we are at the half, with the Warriors trailing by 20. It's 38-18. We'll take a break and come back with our halftime show. You're watching Warriors women's basketball on SSN Canada. Here at the back on the campus of the University of Waterloo, we're enjoying some halftime festivities as the varsity football team took on some rec athletes, and well, they won every task that was put in front of them, and win the first event of the night as part of varsity night Battle of Waterloo. Lots of things coming up here at the PAC, including on January 26th, a 2 o'clock tip-off for the women, 4 o'clock against the men, for the men against Windsor. It's a fantastic alumni, faculty, and staff day. Next action for the Warriors is January 19th in the afternoon, 12 p.m. for the women, 2 p.m. for the men against McMaster, YBA day here at the PAC. And you'll get to find out all kinds of things about what's the makeup of these teams as they continue on in this OUA sked. McMaster will be a quite opponent for both the women and the men. Men with that first victory coming against Western on the road, and they look to extend that tonight here against Laurier. Important matchup for this men's squad, who still mathematically have a shot at the playoffs, as do the women if they can put together a string of victories. Women trailing right now at the half, 38-18. The chance before the season started to sit down with the head coach of the women's basketball squad, Tyler Slip, and chat with him a little bit about where he comes from, his whole backstory about who he is.
Hi, I'm Tyler Slip, head coach of the women's basketball team here at the University of Waterloo. I came to Waterloo, this is my fifth year I'm starting now. Came to Waterloo originally. It was hopefully my last stop on cross-country tour to become the best coach I could be. So spent some time on the East Coast. I spent some time on the West Coast, some time in Ontario, and it's now I'm back here. I come from a basketball family. We call it the family business. My mother was a head coach at the university level for about 20 years, over two stretches of time. She was the captain of the 1976 women's Olympic team in Montreal, starting point guard. My dad played basketball in high school, university, had tryouts with the junior national team. He was a younger guy, so while my mother coached at UNB, my dad assistant coached, and then eventually I got on kind of the into the family business, so we say. So every conversation at dinner was about how's the team doing, how's this athlete reacting, what are you teaching, what are you learning today. So like I've literally been around it since the first day I was born. My mother was pregnant with me. I was due March 22nd, 1982. There was a senior women's national tournament being hosted in Fredericton. My mother's team, she was going to coach if I was past the due date. She was going to play if I was born right on the due date. If I was born early, she was going to play. And as it happened, I came right on March 22nd, right on time. So she missed the first day, got out of the hospital and coached. And literally the first place I went when I left the hospital, my grandmother took me to the gym and walked me along in the upper level, and we watched basketball. I loved the game, like absolutely loved the game, but didn't really realize it until I took a step away from it when I was about high school, grade 11. I said, I don't know. I said, where am I going to go with this? I'm not going to be good enough to go pro. I'm not going to be good enough. I might play university, but even then it was a bit of a question of if I was that good. So I took a year away from the game and didn't play at all and missed it unbelievably, like unbelievably missed it. So the next year I came back and tried to play. I coached. And from then on, it's just been a huge part. I mean, obviously, if my parents were football coaches, maybe I'd be in football. If they were soccer, maybe soccer, right? But the reason I kind of had to make a choice of what I wanted to do, when I was in university, I took computer science, of all things, which I haven't used since I graduated. But I had to kind of make a decision. I remember sitting down and saying, the kind of person I wanted to be, I knew basketball provided me the opportunity to look at my weaknesses as a person, as a human being, and I knew basketball would make me have to confront that. And I knew it was going to be the place where I could become kind of the best version of myself I could be, was to be a basketball coach. And I'm so glad I did. It's a hilarious story, but I was recruiting with my mother. We were hosting the national championships at University of New Brunswick when we coached there. So we were coming around the country recruiting, and we were at the OBA championships for girls basketball, which, as I hope you know, are always hosted in Kitchener-Waterloo. We were sitting at McGinnis Front Row, free little plug for them, but we were sitting in McGinnis Front Row, and we were on the patio that day, and we were just talking about life. And we'd been watching games and seeing athletes and kids play. And I said, you know what, like, I'm ready to go at this. Like, I want to try it. I want to go, like, hard and see if I can do this. And it's kind of, it's unbelievable that I've ended up at the University of Waterloo when it got made. The decision was made, like, less than a block from campus. Obviously, my parents started everything. That's, I realize now that I know so much that I take for granted, that I have taken for granted my teams in the past. About just the right way to act, the right way to behave, the right mentality, mindset has all been second nature to me. So like I owe everything to them in that respect. After University of New Brunswick, I went and coached at the NIDA program in Hamilton. Christine Stapleton, who is now the assistant athletic director here, unbelievably small world, but our assistant athletic director here has done a great job. She was the head coach of the junior national team for Canada's women. They started a program, 12 best high school girls in the country, stayed in Hamilton, lived together, trained together twice a day. Her and Mike McKay were the kind of coaches, and I was the apprentice coach, just there to learn, soak up what I could. It was phenomenal. It was a coaching clinic to me every day. And that really, really shaped a lot of the way I coach, because everything we did with them was conceptual in nature. So it was all like about understanding how the game is played. And the right way to play it. And that maybe to my detriment has been because we've really at Waterloo tried to play the game in such a pure way that I know it's taken some wins off the board for us that we might have had, but I think in the long run it'll be good for us. From there I went out to Simon Fraser University. Coach Bruce Langford is I call him the best coach I've ever been around. He's and not necessarily his technical knowledge, which is great. He's the best motion offense coach in the country, I believe. But I learned so much from him about how to be a leader and how to do it. It's different because I don't think my personality is the typical NCAA coach you see on TV. Kind of the smooth talk and slick, come up with a 100 different ways to talk about the game kind of thing. And Langford was a little bit the same way. He was a different personality, and the way he dealt with his athletes and related to them, they wanted to play for him and wanted to learn from him so much that it's just made him unbelievably successful and effective. So I took so much from that, and I still call him every other week probably to talk about this thing going on with my team, that thing, how have you dealt with this, how would you deal with that. He's been an unbelievable resource for me. I love horrible TV shows. I get sucked into reality TV, Big Brother in the summer. Geez, I'm trying to think about my winter, my fall shows. It tails off a bit in the fall because, as you know, this is like a 16-hour job, 16 hours a day that you got to fit into 14 hours a day. So it's pretty busy in season, but bad TV, absolutely.
Back here at the PAC on the campus of the University of Waterloo, Sam Charles with you. Thanks very much for being with us. It just halftime continues nearly done, about 2 minutes left as we can look at our stats brought to you by the University of Waterloo Athletics Department. GoWarriorsGo.ca for the latest in recreation and varsity athletics, and we've been seeing some of those competitions so far tonight. It's part of Varsity Night, Battle of Waterloo football, taking the first competition at half here. For the Golden Hawks, they're being led by Whitney Eleanor's 12 points, 7 rebounds in her 10 minutes, 5 of 6 from the field, perfect from the charity stripe, 2 of 2. Laura Doyle with 8 points, 3 rebounds in her 10 minutes. She's perfect from the field, 2 of 2. Both of those coming from long range, as well as being perfect from the line, 2 of 2. Yeldon, Luciani, and Hillis all with 5 points. Shank with two and Bonsu with one, rounding out the scoring for the Golden Hawks. The Golden Hawks shot 13 of 35 for 37%, 4 of 9 from long range for 44%, and 8 of 14 from the charity stripe. That 8 of 14 is interesting. The Golden Hawks got to the charity stripe 14 times. The Warriors got to the charity stripe 3 times and were good on 1 of 3. Warriors being led by Erica Persons, 9 points, 4 of 11 from the field, 1 of 5 from long range, and missed her only shot from the free throw line. Then they have Stojakovic, Spiropoulos, McIntyre, and Kunsi with 2 points, and Rodriguez with 1. Warriors being out-rebounded 21-18. Warriors shooting 8 of 27 from the field for 29.6%. 1 of 7 from beyond the arc for 14%, and 1 of 3 from the charity stripe for 33%. Warriors turned the ball over 14 times compared to the Golden Hawks just 6 times, and we keep talking about that consistency of the Laurier program. Coach Falco has put together a squad that even Coach Slip will certainly relinquish the fact and admit the fact that this Golden Hawks team, a team that's equipped and made to make the playoffs every single year. They may not win an OUA championship, but they're created on character and toughness and strong fundamentals. And we asked Coach Slip, you know, doesn't that then spur on recruitment efforts? And he did acknowledge, yeah, that would do that too. The Warriors try to get it inside, and it's knocked away by the Golden Hawks, playing a 2-3 zone. McIntyre lobbing into Spiropoulos. She's got 4 on the shot clock, spinning around on Yeldon, and she gets a drop. Warriors now within 18. It's 38-20. We've played 30 seconds of the third quarter. Hillis will go to the far side. Down into Eleanor, and a whistle on the play. And that'll be a foul on Eleanor. That's her first and the first team foul on the Golden Hawks. McIntyre, well off of the printer. Bonsu giving her plenty of room. Gets to the far elbow and then into Loheed. Loheed will dribble to the right side, spinning around. Hands it off to Person. 4 on the shot clock. Person puts up the shot. Erica shot's a bit long. Bonsu down with the rebound. She'll hand it off to Hillis. Hillis, an 08-09 OUA all-rookie team member. Falco says a nice reverse down low by Osai for her first points of the game. For Hillis, it's Falco's expecting that she'll be a leader on and off the floor again this season for the squad. The Warriors turn the ball over. Hillis on a 3-on-1. McIntyre gets over quickly. That's some nice passing by Hillis and Bonsu. Eventually into Eleanor, who can finish. 8:13 to go. Warriors trailing by 22. It's 42-20. Spiropoulos from the elbow. Kicks it outside Rodriguez. Down inside to Loheed on Eleanor. Shot's a bit strong. Loose ball picked up by Spiropoulos. Outside to Rodriguez. Fresh shot clock, but 20 seconds left on it. As Jackie gets it into Spiropoulos on the pick and sort of roll. And Gia's shot's short off the bottom of the iron. Bonsu gets it up to Osai. Osai over to Hillis. Hillis lobbing it into Yeldon. Strong move as help came from Lohi for Spiropoulos, but the loose ball came over to Eleanor, who's fouled on her shot attempt. We asked Coach Falco to give the Golden Hawks a grade for the season. He says so far it's a B. So there's lots of new faces, and it takes time to get the consistency that's necessary to be good every single game. And in their last two, they certainly saw that against Windsor, played a terrible first half, and then improved in that second half. And then in the game against Guelph, easily handled Guelph, 79-49. Eleanor makes the second, or makes both, and it's 44-20 as Rodriguez loses the handle with a little bit of pressure. And Warriors, it was a bit of a tail of the game against the Mustangs. They hand it off last Wednesday. Eleanor, nice pass into Monsu, finishes from the right side. Coach Slip slamming the scorer's table with his hand in frustration. Pass intended for Persons, knocked out of bounds by Osai. Mismatch in terms of size, and the Warriors have a size advantage tonight against Laurier. A nice wraparound shot where Rodriguez will go to the line for a three-point play. It's the aggressiveness you'll want to see from someone like Jackie Rodriguez as a substitution. Shank replacing Osai. Coolin Devlin and Bear will come in, replacing Loheed and Spropolis. The Warriors go a little bit smaller now. But sometimes, Jackie being in her first year, that aggressiveness we were talking about, get her into a little bit of trouble, stuck in spots where she might travel or turn the ball over. Quickly, again pushing the ball up are the Golden Hawks, and pulling up for the jumper was Doyle, and Doyle has another basket. Bear into McIntyre by herself from 4 feet, hits that one with ease. McIntyre with just the 2 points in the first half as Rodriguez steals the loose ball. McIntyre comes down with it on her feet, or at least on her knees, gets it over to Person. Pull-up jumper. Might have had her arm partially hit by Shank. Another outlet pass intended for Eleanor, who can't save it from going out of bounds. Luciani and Yeldon will replace Bonsu and Eleanor, and Osai will come in for Hillis for the Golden Hawks as the Warriors keep that smaller lineup out there. Person who's been a great addition to this squad, bringing some experience from Sweden, helping out, you know, a very young Warriors team. Nice play by Rodriguez on the continuation, lays it in off the glass, and will again go for an opportunity for a three-point play to the charity stripe. Impressive display so far by the Golden Hawks, leading by 21, 48-27. And for a team that Coach Slip says not that impressive on video, but he did acknowledge that this is a team that can blow you out if you don't play fundamentally well, and there's a long two by Shank. Rodriguez gets to the arc and then slows down, waiting for the play to be run in front of her. Thought about going to her left and then gets it into the left on the wing into Bear, into Person one-on-one with Luciani, and she gets that shot to fall. A little turnaround with the right hand. 50-29. Yeldon travels, trying to make the move on McIntyre, and Sam McIntyre has had a very good game defensively so far tonight, holding her ground against some potentially more athletic players. And Sam, who didn't see that much action in the first half of the season, is seeing a lot more minutes and certainly proving her worth to the squad. Coming from the Queens program 2 years ago, as Bear lobs it into McIntyre, turning around on Shank, a bit strong. Person's there late. Fight for the loose ball. Guess who? It's McIntyre. Fighting for it with Osai, but possession arrow heading in Laurier's direction. Warriors desperately need some stops to just get their... And there's a almost turnover as the Warriors nearly get Osai trapped just at half court. Shot misses, and a foul called as Person and Luciani fighting for position. And it goes against Luciani. And that's the fourth team foul on the Golden Hawks. 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Now if the Warriors can be aggressive, which they haven't been able to do very often in a lot of games, get themselves some free points without time expired. Luciani replaced by Eleanor. Luciani, that was her second foul on Luciani. Rodriguez, head of steam, then kicks it to the charity stripe to McIntyre just inside. nails the jumper. And the Warriors now trail by 19. They are putting a bit of a run together here at the beginning of the second half. And Bear, hate to say it, is a little too aggressive on a slight press. For Bear, that's her first, the second team foul on the Warriors. Schenck, replaced by Doyle for the Golden Hawks. And Osai cuts through the entire Warriors defense and easily lays it in from the right side. 4.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Warriors trailing 52-31. Bear for three. Left wing. That one's a bit strong. Person with the long rebound. She'll pull it back. Then into the paint into McIntyre. Spinning around on Yeldon. Jumper doesn't go too strong. Fight for the loose ball again. Sam's down on the floor. Had it for a moment. Loose ball still on the ground. And a jump ball is called, and possession arrow heading in the Warriors' direction. It'll be a fresh shot clock for the Warriors. Poole and Devlin will be inbounding for the black and gold. She'll lob it up into McIntyre. Warriors trailing at 21. McIntyre for three, just a bit short. Down with it is Chapeau. Chapeau, 2010-11 and 2011-2012 CIS Academic All-Canadian. Eleanor with a strong move to the basket, and a foul will be called on McIntyre. Kate Kunze will get set to re-enter the game. Kate will replace Rodriguez. Kate with four fouls, however. And a timeout called by the Warriors. Warriors trail 52-31. We'll take a break. You're watching Warriors women's basketball on SSN. Here at the PAC on the campus of the University of Waterloo, I'm Sam Charles. You're watching Warriors women's basketball on SSN, brought to you by the University of Waterloo Athletics Department. Go Warriors, go.ca for the latest in varsity and recreation athletics here on campus. 3:51 to go in the third quarter. Warriors trailing 52-31 with Eleanor at the line to shoot two. And finally misses one. She'd been a perfect 4 of 4 until that one. Second shot's up. That one's also short. Good box out by Bear, but wasn't able to handle it. Chaput grabbed it. Over to Yeldon, then outside to Osai. 16 on the shot clock for Laurier as they come to the near side. Into Doyle. Person all over her. Doyle tries to go to her left, does so into Yeldon. Facing up on Spiropoulos. Up the shot, doesn't go. Gia bounces it over to Bear, and Bear will push the ball down court. Up to Spiropoulos. High dribble, nearly got her in trouble. To Kunze, nice move. And then has the ball stripped by Doyle, will remain Warriors ball. Kate, right when she had got the ball, that pass, she had a head of steam, knew what she wanted to do, and made a strong move. You don't always see that. There's sometimes some hesitancy on her part on the down in the paint offensively. Person almost saves it up to Clu and Devlin. Stolen though by Chapeau. Chapeau hands it off to Osai. She'll bring it to the outside, then swing it up to the top. Walking up to the top, and another little hip check from Person. It's been called once on that so far. Doyle from the right wing. 4 seconds to go. Bounces it up to Eleanor. 2 seconds to go as the shot clock expires. Misses the shot. Spiropoulos down with the rebound. And the inbound attempt. Yeldon tried to front. Couldn't see down low, and she'll pick up the foul. That'll be the fifth team foul on the Golden Hawks. Pardon me, on Luciani, the call goes against her. And they call it, it wasn't Yeldon. Luciani's on the bench currently. So Kate is at the line to shoot two. Kate with just the 2 points in the first half and also picked up 4 fouls. Makes the first. Warriors trailing by 20. It's 52-32. Second one is also good. Warriors improving a little bit on their shooting as they try to press, getting the ball down court, but then just a little over-aggressive with that press and pick up a foul. Substitution coming. Rodriguez, wheel replaced person. With that shortish bench, we'll call it shortish, that the short bench that the Warriors have due to injuries. This team not only has not been helping themselves by giving some big leads to their opponents, but it's getting tired in the meantime. Nice hunt there by Spiropoulos to steal the inbound pass, trying to get it into the paint for the Laurier Golden Hawks. Rodriguez, nice pass into Kunze for the jumper at the charity stripe, nails it. Those sorts of moves you'd like to see. Good ball distribution by the Warriors. Chaput for three, left wing, hits the long two. Toes were just inside the arc. 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Reminder, the men's game coming up between Laurier and Waterloo at about 8 p.m. here on SSN Canada. Just follow the link for men's basketball. Coolin Devlin loses the ball. Bonsu lobs it up to Chaput. Chaput with a nice crossover dribble past Bear and lays it in from the right side. It's a 21-point lead for the Golden Hawks on the Warriors. Coolin Devlin down into Kunze spinning around on Eleanor. Nice move. A little too short, though, on the shot attempt. Hillis, long bomb pass. Nice play down low by Bruce, who couldn't finish. Outside for Hillis. That doesn't drop, but Hillis grabs her own rebound. Bruce. And then a whistle on the play. 65 seconds to go in the third quarter. Warriors trailing by 21. It's 56-35. And Warriors have gone on a couple of runs, but it hasn't quite been enough, and they have not been able to consistently slow down this Laurier attack. Initially, Laurier was just doing long bombs, heaving the ball down court to an open player for the better part of that first half, and the Warriors have cut down on that a little bit here in the second half. There's still been a couple of opportunities for Laurier to find that open player down in the front court and get some easy baskets. Coach Slip said this Warriors team coming to this game needed to play consistently and they need to execute not just offensively but defensively. Any slip, he said, would result in some easy points. And he said if the Warriors played the Golden Hawks soft, like Guelph did earlier on the weekend, then it would potentially result in a blowout. Laurier blew out the Griffins 79-49 on Saturday. There's a three-pointer from Bear. 55 seconds to go in the third quarter. Hillis fell off on the right wing, gets past Rodriguez, out to Bruce. Person right in her face, up to Bonsu. Bonsu pass McIntyre. Help comes from Loheed. McKenzie's feet were moving a little bit. And Stojakovic will get set to re-enter the game for the Warriors. She will replace Loheed. Loheed, that's her second foul. Both teams now into penalty with 41.3 seconds to go in the quarter. Bondu with the deep knee bend. Shots up. It's good. Bonsu, a 63% free throw shooter. Averaging about 8.5 points per game for the Hawks. Makes the back end. It's 60-38. Rodriguez into the corner to Bear. Tokovic gets that ball up, but just not enough on her shot. May have been partially blocked by Eleanor. And Bear picks up the foul again as the Warriors try to press. Bruce takes a seat in her place. Jacobs comes in for Laurier. And Hillis misses the first. Laurier averaging 63 points per game. Warriors averaging 53 points per game. Hillis makes the back end. It's now 61-38, 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. Rodriguez into Person. Person driving in, head of steam, ran right into Eleanor, and Eleanor will pick up that foul. Again, both teams into penalty with 21.8 seconds to go in the third quarter. Third foul on Eleanor. This Person makes the first. Bonsu over to Hillis. Bounces it up to Bonsu. Back over to Hillis. 10 seconds to go in the quarter. Person not giving her a whole lot of room. Uses a screen. Switch is made. Stojakovic stays on her. Get into Jacobs. Jacobs puts a shot up as time expires. And that's how things will end after three quarters with Laurier leading Waterloo 61-39. We'll take a break. You're watching Warriors Women's Basketball on SSN Canada. Back here at the PAC on the campus of the University of Waterloo, I'm Sam Charles. This is Waterloo Warriors Women's Basketball, SSN Canada, brought to you by the University of Waterloo Athletics Department, GoWarriorsGo.ca, for everything varsity and recreation athletic based on campus at the University of Waterloo. Next action for the women comes up on Saturday afternoon. It's YBA Day as McMaster comes to town. Women's game at 12 noon, men's game at 2 p.m. on Saturday. Laurier starts with the ball here in the fourth quarter. Good sized crowd here tonight for Varsity Night Battle of Waterloo. Bear almost stole the pass as the Golden Hawks get into Eleanor and is having a terrific game. Lays the ball in and goes to the line for the three-point play. Eleanor now with 19 points, make that 20 on the evening to go along with her 9 rebounds for the Hawks. jumper from the three-point line. Five persons, a bit too strong. Bonsu comes down with it. Quickly up into Jacobs. Jacobs then into Hillis. 14 on the shot clock. Over to Shank. Jacobs again being guarded by Person. Hands it off to Bonsu. Puts the jumper, the charity stripe. That doesn't go. Eleanor there to get the rebound and then is fouled and will go to the line to shoot two. Third foul on McIntyre. Second on the Warriors here in this fourth quarter. Warriors 66-39, the Warriors trail the Golden Hawks. Played 45 seconds in the fourth quarter. Soakovich had the ball knocked away, chased it down to midcourt. Bear knocked it in to Stojakovich. Looks like the foul goes against Eleanor. She'll be replaced by Luciani. That's Eleanor's fourth foul. McIntyre gets it into Person, and then a foul called on the play. That's going to go against Osai. That'll be the second team foul on the Golden Hawks. Trying to track down some stats for Eleanor for the Golden Hawks. Sakovich puts up a shot well short, but Person's there outside to Bear for a long two. Nothing but net. And that's where that size for the Warriors helps. So the Warriors definitely have a little more height. Nice pass from Osai into Luciani. That shot doesn't go, but then there's the rebound that the Warriors miss. Bonsu comes down with it for Laurier. Osai will drive baseline. Help comes. Hands it out to Luciani, who puts up a shot. Doesn't go, but he'll go to the line to shoot two. Rodriguez picking up the foul. It's her third and the team's third foul here in the fourth quarter. Luciani makes the back end. 68-41. Warriors trail. 8.5 minutes to go in the ballgame. Person to McIntyre. Laurier in fifth spot in the OUA West. As Person gets it to McIntyre, three rattles around and falls. And the Warriors continue to press, trying to trap the Golden Hawks as Osai with ease gets past the trap. Over to Bonsu, outside to Luciani for three, hits it from the right wing, answering back on the three ball for McIntyre. 71-44, Warriors trail. Rodriguez with a strong drive from the right side, but a little too strong in the lay-in attempt. Shank, one-on-one with Person, rejected by Erica. Ball remains, Laurier ball, as Lohe and Kulendevelin will come in, replace things, Stojakovic and Bayer. Laurier inbounds it to Luciani with a strong move to her right. High off the glass, doesn't fall, but she'll go to the line, and Lohe will pick up the foul. That'll be the fourth team foul on the Warriors, and the third on Kenzie. Luciani makes the first. And the back end as well. Rodriguez to the far elbow, bounces in into Lohede, one-on-one with the much smaller Jacobs, but McKenzie can't get it to fall, and then Rodriguez gets in there, and this time Lohede banks it off the glass. Good aggressive play by Rodriguez, but then showing her inexperience, being a little over-aggressive with the next inbound pass and picks up a foul. Warrior 7:18 to go in the second half. And that's the fifth team foul on the Warriors already, and will take Osai to the line to shoot two. After three quarters of play, as Osai misses her first, the Golden Hawks had been to the line 24 times, the Warriors just 8. Warriors shooting a better percentage from the line, 5 of 8, whereas the Golden Hawks were at that point 14 for 24. Rodriguez gets to the baseline underneath the basket, tried the reverse on Jacobs, doesn't go, but she'll go to the line to shoot two. It's nice to see this first year with some confidence, and speaking to her before the season and for a number of these games, she's talked about the confidence she's felt. She's played rep basketball, club basketball in the area. She's comfortable playing here at the PAC. And has just had to get used to just this different style of play. Higher level here in the CIS. And she's, and some of her inexperience sometimes shows sort of on the edges, you know, sometimes bringing the ball up down court. We chatted with Coach Slip about that before this game, about how even Laura Burnett having a couple of years experience, you know, it helps just getting out of those pressure situations, getting out of trouble when you're, you know, perhaps the opponent tries to trap you, or you start to drive and you're not quite sure what to do. It's that, you know, extra season or two under your belt when you get that comfort level and things slow down for you. And no question that Jackie Rodriguez will be a special player when that starts to happen. And it's already gradually happening for her already. For the next couple of years, we expect even bigger and better things. Goes off the Warriors. Laurier ball. 74-48. Golden Hawks lead. Jacobs will push the ball down court. 3-on-1 into Luciani. Driving the lay-in from the left side. Too strong. McIntyre grabs it. And it was not a very sound defensive play by Bruce reaching in. Now both teams with team foul trouble. 74-48. Laurier leads Waterloo as we see Bob Copeland, the athletic director of the University of Waterloo, taking a seat high up here at the back, and the crowd continues to file in, getting set for the men's game starting at about 8 o'clock here in SS Canada. Just check the link for the men's action between Laurier and Waterloo. McIntyre, second shot's up. It's good. Sporopoulos will replace McIntyre. And depending on the kind of a press both squads put on, Cullen Devlin with some good feet to try to trap Osai, who gets it up to Jacobs. Then into Chomik, who's just into the game for the Golden Hawks and just missed. She gets it again, Chomik. Luciani over to Chomik again, fake to the left, goes past the screen, and then behind the back pass goes right to Percy for the turnover. Warriors cut down on their turnovers, 14 as the Jake partially blocks Rodriguez's shot. Luciani for three, right wing, hits another one, high, arcing shot, nothing but net. Warriors had 14 turnovers in the first half. They are now at about 19. Laurier just over 10 at this point. Nice move by Gia Sporopoulos, showing some of those moves that she picked up on the Greek junior national team. 5.5 minutes to go in the second half. Warriors trailing by 25 at 77-52. Jacobs with a strong move to the basket. It's knocked out of bounds by Loheed. McIntyre will come in. She'll replace Rodriguez. Bear will come in, replacing Person. And it looks like a timeout about to be called, and it is by Laurier. Just wanting to maintain Their lead currently at 25, 77-52, 5:21 left here in the second half. You're watching Warriors Women's Basketball on SSN. Back here at the back on the campus of the University of Waterloo is this cross-town rivalry between Laurier and Waterloo, and Laurier is out on top at this point with 5:21 to go in the fourth quarter. Warriors trailing 77-52. Laurier with possession, inbounding from the baseline in the front court. Bounce it into Bruce, up to Luciani, and then over to Asai. Osai getting past Spiropoulos, and then over to Laurier, gets it over to Osai as the shot clock expires, and a good defensive stop by the Warriors with 5:10 to go here in the second half. Warriors with Loheed, Spiropoulos, Bear, McIntyre in person on the floor. Loheed with a nice touch pass into Spiropoulos, who can't finish from the left side, and then a whistle on the play. In frustration, looks like Loheed picks up the foul. And Luciani is at the line, and both teams into the penalties, so any foul will result in shots at the charity stripe. Luciani misses the first. According to our stats, he's been perfect on the season thus far. Person, little head fake at the top of the key, then gets it into Bear. Bear loses her dribble, and it goes out of bounds off her leg. Laurier ball. 4:45 to go in the fourth quarter. Jacobs to Osai, to Chomik, into Luciani. Strong shots, no good. Person down with the rebound. Erica up to Spiropoulos, who has it go off her fingertips, out of bounds. And again, another turnover by the Warriors, who'd been pretty good at dropping the number of turnovers in that third quarter. Luciani, nice bounce pass, threading the needle into Bruce, who finishes from the left side. 80-52, Laurier leads Waterloo. Bear lobbing to Spiropoulos. Help came for the Golden Hawks, and Gia was a little strong on the shot. 4 minutes to go. Jacobs and Dan can't get it to drop. Spiropoulos down with the rebound. Warriors heading into this game with a 29-game losing streak. Nice play by Bear banking off the glass. 3:40 to go. Last Warriors win back November 18th, 2011 against RMC. That ended a 30-game losing streak. As McIntyre grabbed the rebound and then a foul is called. Chalmick or Jacobs going to take up that one. Rodriguez and Kulan Develin will come into the game along with Chaput for their respective teams. And it gets no easier for the Warriors in the latter stage of this season, as they do have plenty of home games. 8 home games here in the second half of the season, but against some tough opponents. The next one coming Saturday afternoon, 12 noon, here on SSN Canada. Can't make it out to the pack, of course, as McIntyre makes the first. 12 p.m. tip-off between McMaster and Waterloo. And a line violation called on Chomik, which doesn't work out so well for the Warriors because it looked like Spropoulos was about to grab the rebound. McIntyre's second shot's up. It is good. McIntyre, 63% from the charity stripe this season, improving on that with those two. Nice no-look pass from Osai. First shot doesn't go, but getting the back end as well was Bruce, and she banks it in. There's a whistle on the floor and a timeout called by the Warriors. 3:09 to go in the second half. Warriors trailing 82-56. You're watching Warriors women's basketball on SSN Canada. Back here at the back on the campus of the University of Waterloo, just wrapping up the women's game. Men's game coming up at about 8 p.m. between the Golden Hawks and the Warriors. Tip off at just after 8 p.m. on SSN Canada. Just have to follow the link to the men's action. .309 to go in this ball game with the Warriors trailing 82-56. Good effort tonight by the Golden Hawks, and the Warriors have had spits and spurts of playing very well, but have also given up a lot of open looks. Have not been quite as aggressive as I'm sure Coach Slip would like, and a strong move right there, talking about it being aggressive by Mackenzie Loheed with the left hook, gets it to drop, and she'll go to the line with a three-point play. After three quarters of play, the Warriors had gotten to the charity stripe just eight times. We'll go to 5 of 8. Golden Hawks got to the line 24 times, were 14-24. Another steal. Rodriguez and Nicola Nevelin, who can't handle the pass. And the ball goes out of bounds off McIntyre. It will be Golden Hawks ball. 2:45 to go as the Warriors again try to trap the Hawks. And the Hawks still manage to get it out. They get it down to Luciani, partially blocked by Loheed. Fight for the loose ball. McIntyre up to Rodriguez on a 2-on-1 with Spropoulos. Pull-up jumper from the near elbow. Doesn't drop. Osai had Chomik all by herself, and they seem to just keep that one player in the front court the whole time, open for the easy bucket. And fortunately for the Warriors, they had a defender get back quickly. Chaput takes a seat. In her place is Bruce, who gets the inbound pass. She'll go baseline. Lob doesn't go. Chomik with the rebound. Puts her head down. Bounces it over to Bruce. Loose ball picked by Chomik. And then a three-second violation called on, looks like on Bruce on the play. And with 2:16 to go, Warriors trail 82-58. Rodriguez into McIntyre as the Warriors set up their half-court offense into Spropoulos. Double team comes. Fadeaway jumper is a bit strong. Laurier with the rebound. Walking the tightrope of the sideline was Bruce, and that shot attempt by Chomik's no good, and down with it is McIntyre. Having another good game tonight is Sam McIntyre. A very good one against Windsor, if you exclude the turnover numbers for in the ballgame. 15 points, 11 turnovers in that game. 2-on-1, McIntyre back again. Bounce pass from Bruce into Jacobs. Can't finish. Cullen Devlin knocked it over to Luciani. Less than 90 seconds to go in the ballgame. So the Warriors will drop to a record of 0-12, remain in the cellar of the OUA West. Nice pass from Jacobs. into Bruce, and Bruce gets that one to drop. So Akovich will come in. She'll replace Loheed. Loheed putting up, again, some good minutes in a walk-on just 2 years ago. Started the game tonight for the Warriors. The Golden Hawks will improve to a record of 6-6, including a stellar road record of now 5-1 after tonight. They will reset the clock to 1 minute 13 seconds. Warriors will inbound from the backcourt. 84-58 is the score. Laurier up. So Laurier still has plenty of opportunity to improve on their record from last season, 13-9. They beat Guelph in the first round last year in overtime and then ended up losing to Brock in a lopsided affair in the OUA quarterfinals. Another turnover by the Warriors. Jacobs down into Bruce, and Bruce is fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot two. 58.8 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. And the Warriors, with the loss today, will have a 30-game losing streak that will equal their losing streak of a year ago, as Bruce makes the first. And if you can think back a few years, Warriors beat McMaster in a very tight game. On January 30th, a miss by Rodriguez. Rebound by Stojakovic. She banks it off the glass and in. 50 seconds to go. Back in January 30th, 2010, that ended a losing streak in itself in that season, the 09-10 season. The Warriors had won four games. Not been the same story the last few years. Another turnover this time by Stojakovic. Laurier passes it around, and Chomik picks up the basket. 30 seconds to go. Warriors trailing by 28. Rodriguez passes into traffic right to Chomik. Chomik lobbing it up to Jacobs. McIntyre gets right in her face. Jacobs' shot doesn't go. Rebound to Spiropoulos. Up to Rodriguez on a one-on-three, so she'll slow it down a little bit. Runs into Osai, and then the pass intended for McIntyre is knocked out of bounds by Jacobs. 9.5 seconds to go. Lobs it into Rodriguez, does McIntyre. 8 seconds to go. Backing in Osai over to Spiropoulos. Their jumper is too strong. The rebound down to Chomik. Time will expire, and the Warriors drop this one by 28, 88-60. The Warriors now on a 30-game winning streak. The last Warriors victory back November 18th, 2011. However, if history means anything, we just mentioned it, Warriors beat McMaster for their win, the one most recent after that game against RMC, January 30th, 2010. So perhaps Saturday afternoon, 12 p.m. tip-off, could they end this 30-game winless streak? We will find out. For our producers, Chris Gilbert and Dan Ackerman, the Associate Athletic Director is Christine Stapleton, the Athletic Director is Bob Copeland, I'm Sam Charles. Thanks for watching. The next Warriors women's action is Saturday afternoon at 12 p.m. on SSN Canada. You've been watching Warriors women's basketball on SSN.